So let's take a look at some terms that I'm sure you're familiar with and you've seen all the time. They are the terms byte, kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, and terabyte. And these are terms that are used to describe the memory size and the storage size of your devices. So you could say that your Mac has a hard drive that is a certain number of gigabytes. You can say that the memory on your Mac also has a certain number of gigabytes. So anytime there's a kind of size of digital things, memory or storage, we use these terms to talk about them. Now, the root of all these terms is the byte. So what is a byte? A byte is 8 bits. Bits are either ones or zeros. So for instance, 01, 01, 01, 01, that's 8 bits, that's 1 byte. And a byte is a very convenient term to use in terms of memory because you can store a number in it from 0 to 255. That's what these binary digits do. They store numbers, but instead of decimal, 0 to 9 for the digits, it's 0 to 1. So it takes 8 of them to give you a number between 0 and 255. Now, 1 byte is very useful because you can use it to store a single character, like a letter, like the letter J or K or something like that, or all sorts of different special characters. So it's used a lot when thinking of text. But also you can get groups of bytes together, like 4 bytes gives you a very large range from 0 to a very large number in the millions, and it's useful for defining a single number, a number you might use in a spreadsheet or in a program or something like that. 3 bytes, for instance, can be used to carry 3 numbers from 0 to 255, which could be used to define red, green, and blue colors for a single pixel in an image. So these are just examples of some ways that bytes are used. So you can see how 3 bytes are used for a single pixel in an image, and then you have a very large image, and that takes up not just a few bytes, but actually kilobytes or even megabytes of space on your drive to contain that image. Now, kilo is a prefix that's used to describe 1,000. So you would think a kilobyte is 1,000 bytes. But that's not actually the case. It's 1,024 bytes. See, there's a decimal definition of things like kilo and mega and giga. And there's a binary definition. And the binary definition is not 1,000, but 2 to the 10th power, which is 1024. It's very convenient that 1024 and 1000 are really close to each other, and that's what kind of led to using these same terms between decimal numbers and binary numbers. Now, when we have a byte, it's one single byte. A kilobyte is 1024 bytes, and then each one is a multiple of 1024 more than that. So a megabyte is 1024 kilobytes, etc. So you can see how each one goes up by a magnitude of 1024 more than the previous one. A terabyte holds 1024 gigabytes. So you get a 500 gigabyte drive. You would think that 500 gigabyte drive holds 500 times 1024 megabytes, since 1024 megabytes is a gigabyte. And that in turn it would hold 1024 times 1024 times 500 kilobytes, or 1024 times 1024 times 1024 times 500 bytes. It's not the case though, because what it actually holds is the decimal definition of those things. So it holds 1,000 megabytes, or 1,000 times 1,000 kilobytes. Because of course it's nice to pad those numbers. You can get drives that are 500 gigabyte drives with less bytes on them. So when you get a hard drive that says it's 500 gigabytes, that's a marketing term. They're using the decimal definition of giga. So it's actually 500 times 1,000 to the third power of bytes, not 1,024 to the third power of bytes, which actually when you look at it in terms of binary numbers and on your computer, you get 467 gigabytes. That's why when you buy a 500 gigabyte drive or something like that, and you plug it in and you see how much empty space is on this completely empty drive, you won't find that it's actually 500, it's something less. It's been done since the beginning of people selling hard drives, using the decimal definition to make the hard drive look bigger. Now, one last thing I want to show you is, of course, we don't normally write gigabyte or megabyte or any of that. We abbreviate it. Kilobytes abbreviated with KB, sometimes lowercase k, then MB, GB, and TB. So when you see a 1 TB drive, it means 1 terabyte which means that there is probably 1,000 gigabytes on it. If they were accurate, it would be 1,024 gigabytes, or 1,000,000 megabytes, or 1,000,000,000,000 kilobytes of storage on that device. We use those abbreviations everywhere, even when we're talking about speeds, how many kilobytes per second you can download. And sometimes we use a lowercase b, and that's not kilobyte but kilobit. So when we want to make things look even bigger, we can say, oh, this is this many bits instead of bytes. So a bit being 1/8 of a byte, it makes everything look a little bit bigger. So look for that lowercase b to mean bit rather than byte.